So hello guys, welcome you all to my channel, and now we will start a fourth chapter from NCERT class 6th, Pact with Sun. So let's begin this chapter. Let's talk about the old clock shop. यानी कि क्लॉक के आने का मतलब घड़ी, पुरानी घड़ी की शॉप. So Christmas Eve. ईव का मतलब क्या होता है, एक बार समझ लेते हैं. देखिए, ईव का मतलब होता है संध्या. So क्रिसमस की संध्या को क्रिसमस की संध्या आ चुकी थी. एज लास्ट मिनट शॉपर्स वर गोइंग होम, और आखिरी समय में जो दुकानदार थे वो घर जा रहे थे. अ थिक वाइट शीट ऑफ स्नो ले ओवर साल्ट लेक सिटी यूएसए. एक पॉइंट तो देखिए यहाँ समझने का ये है कि साल्ट लेक जो सिटी है वो यूएसए में है. कई बार साल्ट लेक सिटी, ले का मतलब होता है रखा जाना कहीं. तो स्नो की चादर जो है, सफेद स्नो की चादर जो है वो साल्ट लेक सिटी पर छाई हुई थी यूएसए में. येट द लाइट्स वर स्टिल बर्निंग इन द ओल्ड क्लॉक शॉप एज रे इट्स ओल्ड डीप ऑनर, मतलब पहरा ऑनर जो था वो वहां काम कर रहा था. वर्क ऑन अ क्लॉक ही हैड सोल्ड दैट डे, काम कर रहा था उस घड़ी पर जिसको वो दिन बेच चुका था. नाउ हैविंग फिनिश्ड हिज वर्क रे स्टूड अप एंड वाज ऑन हिज वे टू द बैक रूम व्हेन अ कोल्ड रश ऑफ एयर फ्रॉम द फ्रंट डोर हिट द बैक ऑफ हिज नेक. नाउ कोल्ड रश का मतलब क्या है, रश का क्या मतलब होगा? देखिए, रश का मतलब होता है आगे बढ़ना या फिर जल्दबाजी करना या तेजी के साथ. तो यहां होगा कोल्ड रश ऑफ एयर, बहुत तेजी से आगे बढ़ती हुई ठंडी हवा. ठीक है, ही टर्न टू मीट अ लास्ट मिनट शॉपर. बट हिज ओल्ड वाइज आईज टोल्ड हिम दैट दिस वॉज नॉट अ शॉपर. ही सॉ टू मेन, दो आदमियों को देखा. वन इन हिज 20 जो 20 साल का था, द अदर क्लोजर टू 50 जो दूसरा था वो करीबन तकरीबन 50 का था. नाउ द यंगर मैन रिमेन्ड एट द डोर, और जो यंग जो पुरुष था वो डोर के बिल्कुल पास खड़ा था. द ओल्डर मैन अप्रोच्ड द काउंटर विद नो साइन ऑफ फ्रेंडलीनेस इन हिज आईज. रे वॉज एबल टू हाइड हिज ग्रोइंग फियर एज ही स्लोली पुश्ड अ नोट पैड एंड अ पेंसिल अक्रॉस द काउंटर. तो रे ने क्या किया, वो इस काबिल था कि उसने अपना जो बढ़ता हुआ जो डर था उसे छिपा लिया था. और किस तरह छिपाया, एज ही स्लोली पुश्ड, पुश्ड का मतलब धकेलना. तो उसने धीरे से धकेला एक नोट पैड और एक पेंसिल काउंटर के दूसरी तरफ. ही स्माइल्ड एट द अनफ्रेंडली फेस, वो उसकी तरफ मुस्कुराया. देन pointed to his ears and shook his head from side to side. और उसने अपने कानों को पॉइंट किया और अपने जो अपना सिर है वो दोनों तरफ हिलाया. A quick look of surprise changed the man's face as he studied the notepad. एक चकित कर देने वाली आश्चर्यचकित, जिससे एक बात जिससे जो मैन था वो आश्चर्यचकित हो गया जब उसने उस नोटपैड को पढ़ा था. देन टर्न्ड एंड सेड समथिंग टू हिज फ्रेंड, और मुड़ा और उसने अपने दोस्त को कहा. रे यूज्ड द चांस टू लुक क्लोजली एट द मैन, और रे ने इस चीज का बड़ा फायदा उठाया कि अब उसको चांस मिला है ढंग से देखने का उस बंदे को. पेइंग अटेंशन टू द शेप ऑफ अ गन एंड अ रेस्टलेस हैंड इन द मैन्स राइट कोट पॉकेट, और उसने एक आकृति देखी गन की एंड अ रेस्टलेस हैंड और बेचैन हाथ की इन द मैन्स राइट कोट पॉकेट, उस आदमी के दाहिने कोट की पॉकेट यानी कि जेब में. एंगर बॉइल्ड विद इन हिम, और इस तरह से वो बहुत क्रोधित हुआ. बट इट वॉज कैप्ट डाउन बाय एन इनर वॉइस दैट सेड बी स्टिल. He wrote on that notepad, may I help you? For the first time, the older man looked directly at Ray and smiled, a cruel, mocking smile. They both understood why he was there, why his friend remained at the door. They looked like men who were down on their luck and were now ready to try something they would later be sorry about. The clocks ticked on. Ticked ka matlab kya? Now Ray calmly wrote another message. Usne aaram se, shanti se dusra message likha. Have you come to pick up a clock or watch? Kya aap yahan kuch ghadi ya kuch deewar ghadi khareedne hai? Then he pointed to the lawn board filled with hanging clocks and aur usne point kiya to the lawn board filled with hanging clocks and pocket watches. He was not a broker, but at the same time couldn't say no to the needy people who placed their old watches or clocks before him for anything they could get. He loaned more than he should. They would be there when the owners wanted them back. At the same price he had paid, with no interest. Then the older man seemed to feel a little easier, took out his hand from his pocket and quickly looked at the watch on his wrist. How much will you give me for this? The man wrote. Ray noticed a little shame in the grey eye looking at him. The watch was nothing special and yet had great powers. It was something to exchange, a way out of a bad situation. Knowing that great need had brought the man to his shop in the first place, Ray asked, how much do you need for it? The reply came on the notepad, whatever it's worth. Ray reached into his cash box, pulled out a $50 note and passed it into the man's hand. As they shook hands, Ray looked into the man's eyes. They seemed to say, thank you. They both knew the watch wasn't worth that much. Before turning to leave, the man wrote, I will be back to pick it up as soon as I can. Merry Christmas. The little story ended on the half hour, with the clocks striking altogether. The time pieces, which had been looking on silently all the while, rang out the time with such feeling that even Ray thought he could hear them. Their sweet musical message was filled with hope, the timeless message of peace on earth, goodwill towards all, was felt by the three men who stood in the old clock shop. Now, what made Ray think the visitor was not really a shopper? So when he looked the man closely, then he found a gun-shaped thing and his restless right hand inside the right side of his coat pocket. As well as the old man looked like his smile was very cruel and so that's why he found that the visitors are not shoppers or customers. Why do you think he had come to the shop? He came to the shop to steal things, to loot the loot Ray. How did Ray communicate with them? Ray communicated with them through a notepad and with a smile on his face, with having a smile on his face. What do you think the man said to his friend who waited at the door? I don't know. I really don't know what. Why was he at the door? Ray was not. I think he was at the door just to see whether someone is coming from outside. Someone was coming from outside or not. So he was basically at the door to take care or so that they can do whatever their misdoings. So he can kind of accomplice to the burglar who was inside the shop. Ray was not up on Bombro. Why then did he lend money to people in exchange for their old watches and cloaks? I don't know. The watch was nothing special and yet had great powers. In what sense did it have great powers? Ray said that because he knew that in that situation these kind words and then inspirational words will affect the would affect the old man, because he knew that he is not a shopper, he is not a customer, and the ulterior motives were not to buy something. So that's why he find the man is a burglar and he came there to loot. So that's why he try to butter the man with these kind of words. Do you think the man would ever come back to pick up the watch? Maybe he said that he will come back, but definitely he will not, because he also knew that the watch wasn't worth that much. He got $50 for that, and he knew that they are way more than the reality, the real cost of that watch. So when did the unfriendly face of the visitor turn truly friendly? So when the visitor, when Ray asked about his watch, how much it cost him, so, or what's the worth of it? So the, because he's a needy man, so that's why he got some interest in that conversation. So that's why the visitor turns truly friendly towards Ray. So this is it for today. We'll meet you tomorrow with a new story. So stay tuned. Bye bye.